here we can see the three points. First point, green streak fractures. Then signs and symptoms. What is the difference between signs and symptoms? Then third point is salpingectomy. Let us see. First one, why green streak fractures occurs mostly in children? Because children's bones have not calcified or hardened. Their bones are much more flexible than adult bone. Green streak fracture bone bends and breaks, usually occurring in infancy and childhood. Their bones have not calcified or hardened. So, green streak fractures happening. Types of fracture. Oblique fracture. That means fracture that is diagonal to a bone's axis. Compression fracture usually occurs in the vertebra. The action of compressing usually occurs in thoracic spine region, that is middle portion of the spine. Occurs as part of aging, fall, lifting heavy objects, etc. So compression fracture usually occurs in the vertebra. Spiral fractures, some of the bones has been twisted. Spiral fractures occurs due to rotational twisting force, usually affect any long bones. Example, tibia. Spiral fractures usually affect any long bones. Example, tibia. Spiral fractures occurs due to rotational twisting force. Comminuted fracture, a fracture with a bunch of fragments. Comminuted fracture, a fracture with a bunch of fragments. Compacted fracture, a fracture when the bones are driven into each other. Compacted fracture, a fracture when the bones are driven into each other. Comminuted fracture happening usually in the small bones in the hands or feet are highly susceptible to comminuted fracture. So comminuted fracture usually happening in small bones. Commonly occurs after vehicle accidents, car accidents like. So compacted fracture, a fracture when the bones are driven into each other. Comminuted fracture, fracture with a bunch of fragments. Then what is the difference between signs and symptoms? Plus related points also we can see. What is sign? Signs are what examiner sees, what nurse or doctor sees. The manifestation of a disease that can be observed by the doctor or nurse. That is a sign. Examples of sign, that is heart rate, color, temperature, swelling of glands. All these can be examined by the doctor or nurse or any other health professionals. A symptom is an effect noticed and experienced only by the person who has the condition. So patient can feel the symptom. That is symptom. An effect noticed and experienced only by the person who is affected. Example, stomachache, headache, all are the aches symptoms. That is a symptom. Indications of salpingectomy. Salpingectomy refers to the surgical removal of a fallopian tube. Salpingectomy refers to the surgical removal of a fallopian tube. What are the indications of salpingectomy? Ectopic pregnancy, infected fallopian tubes, ruptured tubal pregnancy, uncontrolled bleeding, cancer of the fallopian tube. These all are the indications of salpingectomy. I will read one more. Ectopic pregnancy, infected fallopian tubes, ruptured tubal pregnancy, uncontrolled bleeding, cancer of the tube. An ectopic pregnancy. What is ectopic pregnancy? Ectopic pregnancy, when a fertilized egg implants and grows outside the main cavity of the uterus. An ectopic pregnancy, when a fertilized egg implants and grows outside the main cavity of the uterus, that is ectopic pregnancy. An ectopic pregnancy most often occurs in a fallopian tube. An ectopic pregnancy most often occurs in a fallopian tube.
So that's all for today's video. We studied types of fractures, difference between signs and symptoms, and self-injectomy. I think you will remember these three points for your examination.